You know, one of the best things about doing the JRPG weekly update is just getting to chill for a while and have some coffee with you guys. So, cheers. Morning to you, and welcome back to today's JRPG weekly update. I am Super Derek, and Tokyo Game Show has been going on this whole week. It's been kind of a mixed bag, to be totally upfront, but there is some pretty interesting things that we will be talking about today, some interesting discussions that are going to result of some of these things, I think. But you know, let's just go ahead and start by talking about some new games and ports that were announced this week, starting with announcements from Konami of some RPGs that were based on a manga called Eden's Zero. Now, this is a manga, is a sci-fi adventure by the same mangaka, the same writer, the same illustrator behind Fairy Tail. His name is Hiro Mashima, or Mashima. And apparently, one of them is going to be a mobile game, but the other one is going to be a third-person action RPG for consoles. Now, the game appears to be getting a Western release, given that the trailer was released with English letters, words. It says stuff in English, in text form, I'll say it that way. And it looks, I mean, they didn't really say it's coming to the West, but I think the implication is pretty much there. Now, there's no real release window provided here for either game, but I mean, it looks good based on the trailer. It looks like, you know, the Fairy Tail RPG. It looks fine, but it's by Konami. And because of that, I can't really say I'm gonna be holding my breath over this one. Now, also, Atelier Ryza 2 is got a trailer at the Tokyo Game Show, and that confirmed that the game is also going to be coming to PlayStation 5, which is really excellent. Players of Ryza 2 on PlayStation 4, both physical and digital purchasers, are going to get a free upgrade over to the PlayStation 5 version. So, you know, there's that. I guess some people are actually like charging for this, which is interesting. But yeah, some people are just some de some game developers are just like, hey, if you bought it, you have it, and I like that. Now, Atelier Ryza 2, The Lost Legends and the Secret Fairy is set to launch in North America and Europe within the winter launch window this year. So, or I guess not this year. Winter could be as late as like February next year, but winter. So, you know, knock on wood, we'll see that sooner than later. Also, Nier Reincarnation is coming to the West, which is kind of interesting. This is that mobile game by, you know, the same team. Can't remember the guy's name. He's a weird one, though. I remember that much about him. Weird moon face guy. Not really much else is known about the Western release at this point. And also, it's a mobile game, so it's like, it looks neat, again, but it's mobile, and I'm always conflicted when it comes to mobile. Always. But, you know, we'll probably talk about that a little bit more. Now, in release date updates, Brigandine: The Legend of Runeterra has a release date update. It's going to be coming to PlayStation 4 on December 10th of this year, and the English version is getting a physical copy that will be distributed through Limited Run Games. So make sure you keep an eye out for that. Also, we were just talking about Nier. In the same breath, they also mentioned that Nier Replicant version 1.01189998 1991197253 is going to be coming to PlayStation 4, the Xbox One, and Steam on April 23rd. So we've got a release date for that, which is awesome. Following that, the previously announced mobile game for Octopath Traveler, Champions of the Continent, is going to be coming to PlayStation. I'm sorry, not PlayStation, coming to iOS and Android in Japan. But that Western release has not been confirmed yet. But I kind of, based on the trailer, again, I'm conflicted because it's a mobile game. I wish it was coming to PlayStation. But it looks interesting. It looks like it's not just your run-of-the-mill mobile game. It looks like, you know, a console experience where you're actually like exploring and stuff. It's conflicting. I'm conflicted today about a lot of the news that we're seeing so far. Also, in other news, Final Fantasy 16 has recently been rated by the ESRB, which is really interesting that it's already been rated. I suppose that it must be coming out closer than we expected. I suppose. Furthermore, the game is rated M, which I kind of probably could have guessed from the shower of blood all over that child in the trailer. I'm guessing most of us could have guessed that, and I don't think anybody expected it was going to be AO, so we probably could have deduced this much, but it's interesting, and that's about why we're talking about it. Also in other news, Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memory is going to be getting a demo here in mid-October, so that demo is going to be coming to PlayStation 4, Nintendo Switch, and Xbox One, and then the full release of the game will occur in November on the 13th. In Super Derek news, on Friday this week, I will be releasing my review of Trails in the Sky SC, and I'm really excited for it. So far, as of right now, supporters of the show via Patreon or people who have subscribed to me over on Twitch currently have early access to that video, and they're enjoying it quite a bit. If you are interested in becoming a supporter of the show, I'll have links down in the description down below. Basically, $1 a month gets you early access to the videos that I put out. So if you're interested, I will just put the link there. And then we got a little bit of rumor mill news, not a whole lot of super, you know, hot goss or anything like that. But, you know, there have been rumors surrounding a potential Mass Effect trilogy remaster that has been apparently in the works. Now, initially, those rumors hinted at an October announcement. However, it looks like the main outlet for these rumors, VentureBeat, says that they've heard now that that has been pushed back until 2021 for that announcement. So if you've been waiting for this announcement, you'll have to wait a little bit longer. And that leaves us with today's JRPG Weekly Forecast, starting with today, September 28th, Genshin Impact, the free-to-play action RPG by the Chinese developer miHoYo, is coming to PlayStation 4, iPhone, iPad, and PC. And then, a game called Undead Darlings, No Cure for Love. This is a first-person dungeon crawler and visual novel gameplay sort of game where you battle your undead girlfriends against the hordes of monsters in the dungeons. I can't make this up. It seems like, honestly, this is the one that caught my eye the most today. Like, this seems like a really interesting, maybe Halloween-themed, I don't know, waifu fighter. Anyways, it's coming to PlayStation 4, PC, and Nintendo Switch. And then to follow that up, we've got on Thursday, October 1st, Warsaw, which is a World War II-based tactical RPG by developer Pixelated Milk. It's coming to PC, PS4, and Xbox One. And then East Origin, Falcom's classic action RPG series prequel, is coming to Nintendo Switch. It is already on PC, PlayStation 4, Vita, and Xbox One. And then we got a couple of Kemco RPGs here, starting with Liege Dragon, which is coming to the Nintendo Switch. It is already on Xbox One and PC. And Dragon Lapis, like Lapis Lazuli? I don't know. Anyways, it's another Kemco-style, retro-style RPG. It's coming to the Nintendo Switch, and it is also already on iPhone, iPad, and 3DS. So that one's kind of more mobile-based, I suppose. And now it's time for today's question of the week. Now, as you may have noted from my backlog of reviews, I'm not, generally speaking, a mobile RPG player, but a lot of the games that were talked about this week are kind of interesting. They sort of appeal to me a little bit, and it's got me kind of wondering, what would it take for you guys to consider playing a mobile RPG, or do you already play them? And I'm not really sure what it would take for me to actually start playing more of them. I mean, I've played some of them. I've played, Shin Megami Tensei DX2. I've played some Romancing Saga Reuniverse, as you likely know, and I've enjoyed my time with them pretty well overall. But one of the things that I really wish that I could have, I think, as in a mobile experience, is something that's more geared toward the epic storytelling, the world exploration. And I feel like those elements of RPGs are sort of underrepresented on the mobile RPGs that I've been playing through. And I think that that's probably what it would take, is something that was maybe some solid gameplay mechanics and also having a really compelling story and exploration and leveling system, something where I would have a maybe less unique experience as far as people consider like the, I mean, like the gacha games where you always have a different party. I'd like to have my core game of like of a set character group. You know, I think that would be the direction I would probably prefer to see, I guess. But at the same time, I would still, before I'd even want to play it, I'd, for any extended duration, I would want a more comfortable way of playing it, you know, with a controller or something. And then I'm just wanting more of a console experience, so I'm not really sure. But, you know, speaking of those games that have the exploration and have the epic storytelling, it looks like maybe based on the trailers for the Nier Reincarnation and Octopath Traveler, the mobile game that they showed off, it looks like maybe those are going to sort of fulfill some of my wish list. And I'm just conflicted. So what do you think? Are you already a mobile RPG player? And if so, is it the new wave? Is it your preference? And if you're not, what would it take to get you on board with some mobile RPG gameplay? Anyways, guys, thanks for hanging out with me and enjoying your coffee today. I am Super Derek, and this has all been news to me. Have a great week, everybody.